Even though there might be hatreds coming your way, even your life might be threatened to the death, do not even bring a graven image to make it happen to be his comparison. The three Hebrew boys has given us the warning. Do not even account anything to me the equality of having to live that life to be pleasing unto the
Lord.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego have given their testimony. Even their life were on the line already. You cannot bring anything in comparison to living this life to be pleasing unto him. There's no comparison to the life of Jesus. From the day of his arrival upon the earth, he lived that life that was pleasing unto his Father. As he went down to the river Jordan, and then John says, I'm the one that you should come down for you to be baptized. Jesus said, go ahead and confirm the word and fulfill the prophecy. As the exchange is now taking place and going on, the Lord God is in sight of this whole. Even though it's difficult for John to go on and make this baptism happen, but afterward, it says in the heaven he opened up and the voice came, this is my beloved son, hear him. They heard the same voice within the Mount of Transfiguration as they have now observed the scene of having seen Abraham, and they like the atmosphere, and they say, let us just build a mansion, one for you, one for Abraham, one for us. But you can hear the voice from the heavenly, this is my beloved son. It is not surprising to us to hear incidents after incidents of how the son has lived a life that is pleasing unto his father. Even to the time when he came to pray within the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, not my will be done, but let your will be done. If you so desire to live a life that is pleasing unto the Lord God, forget about your choice and live that which is ordained by him. Throw out your good ideas, any other desire you might have, and follow exactly the commandment that has been given. If you want to live that life that is pleasing unto the Lord God, for Pharaoh has given us the instruction this morning. If my people humble them, who are called by my name, humble themselves,
and I want,
and then pray,
and
then seek my face. Scripture goes on to say, and turn it away from the wicked ways. It says that I will hear from heaven, forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. If you so desire this day to be blessed by Jehovah,
If
you so desire to really drink of the blessing, live in a life that is pleasing unto Him. Jehovah God says, if the people who are called by my name humble themselves, humble themselves and pray and to seek His face diligently, turn them away from your wicked ways. He says, when He has, He will be pleased in such a way that He will hear from heaven. It says He will forgive your sins. When this, the Lord God is pleased, He will heal your life. I believe you desire for you to be restored, for your church to be restored, for your land to be restored. All of this will be possible if we live that life that is pleasing. The real challenge comes to us in a real time factor. Ask yourself before you disclose a word from your mouthpiece if it is pleasing unto the Lord. Before you do any task or do anything, ask yourself, is this going to be pleasing unto God or
not?
Before you depart to go somewhere, ask the Lord God if this is going to be pleasing unto
you.
It does not make no difference. It does not need to have any other consideration. In all that you do and to consider, ask the question if it is pleasing unto you, God, or not. While the singers are ready to come, I want you to ask individually this question for yourself. In the light of the theme that we have for this week is to live a life that is pleasing unto God. Ask the question individually if the Lord is pleasing with your life. If the Lord God pleased where I am, is it pleasing unto Him the words that I uttered from my mouth?
Is
your desire to be blessed not only in this generation, but those that will come and to follow you, live a life that is blessing unto the Lord.
I'm going to live like the way you want me to live.
Amen.
I'm going to try to live the way you want me to be.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to live the way you want me to live.